Hey Life Group, it's great to see you guys once again. Here we are on a beautiful late June morning, kind of rainy, a little cold, but got dressed for it. So man, excited that the Lord is doing such great things in our life groups. And really super proud of you guys for just getting together and building a relationship with one another and with the Lord. And right now we're going through the series of the fruit of the Spirit. God has placed His Spirit within us, and the fruit of His Spirit is being worked out in our life, and it looks like love. And I'm so glad we don't have to try to make it happen. We don't have to try to make love and joy and peace and patience and kindness and goodness and all these things. We don't have to make them happen. They naturally produce in our life as we allow the Spirit of God to just flow through us and respond and are obedient to Him and obedient to His Word. And the Word says this concerning the fruit of the Spirit. It says the Holy Spirit produces this kind of fruit in our life. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And there's no law against these things. In other words, it's something that we can freely do. You know, we can freely live this way. There's nothing that prevents us. And I want to look at one of those fruits of the Spirit this morning or this afternoon or this evening, whenever you're getting together in your life groups. And the fruit of the Spirit of goodness. Goodness is a form of worship. It's an act of worship. It's something that we can do to please God. Really, that's kind of the biblical definition of goodness. In Genesis chapter 1, the Word says that God looked at everything that He created. God looked over all that He had made, and He saw that it was very good. Everything He made, and He said, this is good. And what that means is it pleased Him. He was blessed by what He had done, which God does that. He does great things. He does things perfectly, and He's pleased with what He's done. He's pleased with you. He's pleased with I. I'm so thankful, you know. But He looked at creation, and He said, this is very good. And the idea is it pleased Him. And see, that's what you and I are called to do as the fruit of the Spirit is working in our life, and it's producing this goodness. It's, I'm choosing to say, I'm going to respond, Lord, to Your Spirit's prompting in my life. I'm going to respond to Your Word, and I'm going to please God with what I set my hand to. I'm going to please God with the words that come out of my mouth. I'm going to please God in loving those around me that are not so easy to love. I'm going to please God by saying no to the lusts of my flesh. I'm choosing to say, Lord, I'm going to live my life this way. It's a fruit in my life that is being produced. And I know it's happening in your life too. And we can squelch that. We can resist that if we desire. But God desires for us to just, you know, please Him in everything that we do. And I wonder, I ask you, you know, is that your frame of mind? You know, is that the condition of your heart? Is that the condition of my heart of arising in the morning and saying, Lord, I want to please You today. Whatever I set my hand to today, when I go off to work, you know, when I go off to school, well, we're in break right now, you know, but wherever I'm going today, however I'm living today, Lord, I'm going to please You with my life that I live, by the words that I speak, by the generosity of my heart, by the generosity of my life. I'm just going to allow You, Lord, to be blessed by me today. Second thing I want to look at concerning the goodness of God is that He is good. Not only does what He do or what He's created really good and pleases Him, but He's just, His character is good. Matter of fact, it says in Psalm 73, God is truly good, or truly God is good. Man, He has placed that goodness in us. And I think a lot of Christians today, man, we walk around defeated because we have this mindset, man, I'm a filthy wretch. I'm a sinner. I've been taught that, you know, there is none good. No, there's none righteous. No, not one. And my righteousness are as filthy rags. It's true. That's what the Word does say before we're made new creations in Christ. But when we're new creations and we're believers and we're living in the new covenant and we've placed our faith in Christ, His Spirit has come into us, and now I've been completely transformed, and I have goodness in me now. I'm no longer this constant state of, you know, separation from God and sinfulness and unrighteousness and unholiness. Now I can rise in the morning and say, you know what, Lord? You've made me good. You've made me righteous. I'm the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. The Bible says that as a man thinks, so he is. You know, and if we think that we're these wretched, filthy sinners that are always blown it, that are unrighteous, well, guess how we're going to live? We're going to live that way, you know. But when we understand, man, I'm a man of love. I'm filled with the Spirit of God. I'm a man of joy and peace and patience and kindness and goodness. And so, I understand that God has placed this good in me and I get to live it out. So do you, you know. Matter of fact, if you've noticed in the last 6 months or so, we've been singing this song concerning the goodness of God. It's called Forever Reigns. And there's a phrase in that that says, he is good, and there's nothing good in me. We've changed that. We've changed that line. You may have noticed that when you're singing that song on the overheads. We've changed that line and to say, he is good, and he's placed his good in me. No, there's good in me. It's not that I'm in and of myself a good person. No, the Spirit of God is in me, and I get to live this goodness out. I'm empowered to live a life that pleases God, and so are you. And so, in conclusion, you know, as we break up, and maybe we're going to go into our disciple-making groups, or perhaps we're going to just dialogue concerning these things together after the video is over right here. And I want to ask these questions. It's good for us to ask this among one another as we talk about this. Is how can I please God this week? You know, how can I please Him in my life? And what prevents me from pleasing Him? What prevents me? And then just to pray together, to come together, to worship, and just to speak His name. So God bless you guys. Have a great week, and we'll see you next week.